As schools resume nationwide in line with federal government directives, concerns are mounting in Plateau State over the continued stay-at-home by primary school teachers across the 17 local government areas of the state due to unending labor tussle. AIT's correspondent, who has been monitoring the development, now reports.
It's been 5 days now since the federal government directed schools to reopen across the country amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. But as you can see, this government school has been under lock and key due to an unending labor tussle in the state.
The situation is the same in all public primary schools across the 17 local government areas of the state, thereby raising fresh concerns by parents.
If other schools, especially the private ones, are in schools and the public schools are closed, obviously the government has failed.
I think it's only proper that they should come to a rallying point and please go back to school.
Perhaps the implication of having children stay at home is eating them up.
There's no parent that will be happy. No, you wake up in the morning till the following night and then wake up and then till the following day with the kids at home doing nothing. It's totally uncalled for.
You can see how these Sarasuka are bastardizing people. You can see these kidnappers. It's all because of lack of education. The government have to be proactive.
State Chairman of the NUT, Ayubagana, who confirmed the development in a telephone conversation, blamed the situation on government's refusal to pay their salaries since November last year, as well as implement the 30,000 naira new minimum wage.
Just like other public schools, this place is deserted, and unless the lingering issues are addressed, the future of pupils in public schools on the plateau hangs on the balance. Damasani Dan Kwada, AIT News, Jos.